Hello and welcome. In this video, I will tell you what uContext is, and how this set of utilities will improve your workflow and simplify your work with content. I will talk about the features of the asset very briefly, skipping a lot of small things, but still it will be a rather long video, because uContext contains a lot of features. Two important things before we get started. Firstly, I will talk about the features of uContext 1.9. uContext is very actively developing, and if more than a month has passed since the publication of this video, most likely uContext has at least one big update with new features, so look at changelog to find out about new features that are not in this video. Secondly, in this video I will use keyboard shortcuts for Windows. For OS X, use Command instead of Control in all the shortcuts that I mention. So, what is uContext? uContext is an all-in-one set of deeply integrated utilities that improves the Unity editor, simplifies the workflow and work with content, and fixes the built-in behavior of the Unity editor. Each feature uContext of which can be fully customized or disabled. Some of the features are present only in uContext and currently have no analogs in Asset Store. The main key feature of uContext is the general context menu for the Unity editor, which brings together a huge number of things in one place. Right-click in Scene View, or use the Control plus Space shortcut in any window to open the context menu. The context menu consists of three sections: Breadcrumbs, Actions, and Windows. Breadcrumb shows you the name of a selected game object, and gives you the ability to quickly navigate vertically and horizontally. When you right-click on the name of a game object, you open the context menu for game object. The Action section contains actions that you can perform for a scene, view, or game object. In this video I will not talk about all the actions, but later in this video you can see the use of some of these actions. The Windows section contains the main Unity Editor windows, which you can open as a pop-up, utility, or tab. In addition, this section contains all the components of the selected game object, any of which you can open in a separate window. The component will be displayed as if it were part of the inspector and supports a custom editors, including Odin Inspector and Serializer. A component opened as a tab or utility will always be available even if game object has lost selection. Just imagine that you can make your own layout from your key components and scriptable objects, and always have them at hand. Awesome! There are several more ways to open a component. Hover over an element in a hierarchy while holding Control to see all the components on this game objects. Or simply drag a component from the inspector to the scene view while holding Control to open it in the window. By default, the built-in selection behavior in Scene View is quite unpredictable, because very often you don't know what exactly will be selected when clicked. While it improves this behavior, hold Control and hover over a game object. While it highlights game object in Scene View and hierarchy and displays its name. This will allow you to very quickly search and select the desired object in the scene. But what if your game object is behind another game object, or do you want to select some parent game object? Hold Control plus Shift and while it will show you the names of all game objects under the cursor. Press Control plus Shift plus Space to start smart selection, and select any game object under the cursor or any parent element. In addition, Highlighter can highlight game object in Scene View when hovering over it in the hierarchy window while holding Control. uContext allows you to save the current scene view as a view state. Open the context menu, select Views and Cameras, View States, Create. Enter the name view state. Now, anytime you need, you can return to this state. Open the view gallery. The default shortcut is Control plus Shift plus G. This window combines views from all your cameras and all view states. Click on any item to restore the scene view state. Just imagine that you can create view states for the UI and the most important places in your scene, and switch between them in a second. uContext allows you to bookmark any object from a scene or project. A bookmark can be an object of any type, for example, game object, component, texture. Open the context menu and open the bookmarks window. Drag any object into this window to create a new bookmark. Bookmark the most important objects for you and you will always have them at hand. Then you can quickly select a game object in a scene, open a component in a window and drag an object into scene view or other editor windows. Object Placer allows you to quickly create a new game object and instantiate a prefab in Scene View. Hover over the place where you want to create a game object and press Control plus Shift plus right click to open Create Browser. Create Browser consists of three sections. The bookmarks section contains all the prefabs you bookmarked. The create section contains elements from the hierarchy create. The prefabs section contains all the prefabs in the project. Select the element that you wanted to create, and it will be created exactly in the place where the cursor was when you open create browser. Smart Search combines the search for game object and components in the scene, assets in the project and item in a Windows menu. Press Ctrl plus F to display the search box under the cursor. Using the Tab key, you can change the source whose elements you want to search. Start typing the name of what you are looking for, and Smart Search will show you the most suitable results. Double-click on an item to perform the default action, or right-click to open the context menu. Or you can drag and drop items into Scene View or other windows. If you enter only lowercase characters, the search ignores case. If you enter at least one uppercase character, the search begins to be case sensitive. Smart Search supports camel case search. Enter the first letters of the words in uppercase, for example, SC to find skybox camera. Search by object type is supported. Enter a colon in the type of the object, in whole or in part, to search by type. For example, LS:W to search for a lighting settings window. Using the preview feature, you can see how your scene looks from different cameras without losing the current view. For someone, this feature may seem strange and useless, but if you are a level designer, this may be one of your most favorite and frequently used features. Just imagine that you can set up multiple temporary cameras and see how the scene looks without losing the current view of the scene view. To start the preview of cameras, hold down Ctrl plus Shift plus Q in Scene View and you will see the camera image right in Scene View. Use the mouse wheel to switch between cameras. Press F to set the current camera view to Scene View. Unity Editor does not have a built-in way to replace game objects, and when you need to replace multiple game objects in your scene, this will require a lot of routine work. With UContext, this is a very simple and quick operation. Just select the game objects you want to replace and select Replace Action in the context menu, or use the shortcut Ctrl plus Shift plus H. Create Browser opens in Replace mode. Select a prefab or a new element, and all selected elements will be replaced to new element, and preserving position, rotation and scale. Select two or more game objects, select Group Action from the context menu, or use Ctrl plus G shortcut and enter the name of a new parent game object. A new game object with the specified name will be created, located in the nearest common parent game object, if present, or in the root of the scene. Selected game objects will be moved as children for the new game object, preserving the location in the scene. UContext contains many editor behavior improvements that should be in the Unity Editor by default, but for some reason are missing. You can quickly switch between Scene View and Game View by pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus Tab. This also works when the current window is maximized. Use Ctrl plus Mouse Wheel to quickly change the size of the Terrain Editor brush. By default, pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus A displays the Add Component window in the inspector, next to the Add Component button. This does not work if the inspector is not currently visible, for example, with a maximized window. UContext overrides this behavior and when you press Ctrl plus Shift plus A, the Add Component window will be displayed under the mouse cursor, regardless of whether the inspector is currently visible. By default, pressing F2 starts renaming the active element in the selected window, for example, game object in the hierarchy, or an asset in the project. UContext overrides this behavior and when you press F2, when the focus is on the scene view, inspector, component window or the context menu is open, a window for renaming the selected game object will open. UContext has the ability to group rename game objects using tokens. In addition, UContext can maximize the game view in the play mode by a shortcut, improves drag and drop behavior on canvas, adds the ability to quickly zoom in and zoom out, has the concept of temporary objects that will be destroyed when the scene starts, and has integration with inline maps and real-world terrain. Thank you for watching. Link to YouContext in the description.